can very easily map your PyBatch database structure to, let's say, the S88 procedural control model. Here's an example where we have our PyBatch database diagram on the right and a procedural control example on the left, where the recipe would be reflective of the PyBatch. The PyBatch is a single recipe that you're running. The unit procedure would be a specific run, a specific unit run of a particular within a particular batch. And then those might have in turn operations and phases. Let's look at an example of how you might structure that. Let's look at the pie campaign level. This would be a product. And our example that we have here is chicken nugget barbecue style. Each pie batch is a batch number of that product. So batch 123, 124, 125. These would be successive pie batches. And when you get down to the unit, the pie unit is where everything in the physical world takes place. So the unit batch is where the actual production is taking place. And in this case, we have five units that are involved in the unit batch level of our classic batch example. Churning, breading, frying, freezing, and packaging. Those are the steps involved in running one pie batch. And most likely those involve five different units, five different pieces of machinery that run these particular unit batches. And let's look at one breading, for example. Let's say there's a breading machine. It might have sub-batches of pre-dust, batter, and breading. These might be all operations or phases within the breading unit batch. Here's another example. We have a campaign, which is a paper process order. And this process order might contain many grades of paper. And so we take one grade, that would be considered the pie batch level. And then when you get down to the actual machines that are rolling the paper, that is where the unit batch lives. And this particular grade 15 might consist of five different reels. And we'll take one reel, for example. This may have three different pieces to it, all strung on one reel, and they have there's one, two, and three sections, and each of these might be considered sub-batches. So there's a couple examples of how you might apply the S88 standard to the PyBatch database structure. Other examples of PyBatch applications, downtime tracking, transition between production runs, grade transition, so on and so forth. So there's a lot of different types of batches that you can do that you may not consider traditional batches. They may not be a specific lot or run of a particular product. You might simply be tracking something that's repeatable, like downtime or transitions or even performance. All these can be considered PyBatch applications. There are many applications that are designed to write to the PyBatch database. Of course, there's our PyBatch generator that's often referred to as PyBagen. Our event file interface also is an alternative to the batch generator. Both of these applications will create batch database structures in your batch database. There's also a batch database editor that we'll see a little bit later, as well as programmatic access through the OLEDB provider and SDK-based applications. Lots of different applications read data. Primarily, we've got batch view, process templates, and RT reports. There's also, again, the batch database editor and the SMT, which you can use to see batch data information, as well as any custom application provided by an SDK or API-based application, or relational database interface, or OLEDB provider. So there's lots of different ways to write and read data from the PI database. Primarily, we're going to be involved in this class on looking at the PI batch generator to write data to the database, and batch view and the SMT tool to read data from the PyBatch database.